There is a pleasant surprise coming from Tesla vehicles built at Giga Berlin factory with BYD batteries, as Tesla Model Y with BYD batteries demonstrated high charging performance. Actually, it demonstrates now, and I'm going to tell you about that in a moment. Welcome back, everyone. This is Armin Harayan on this Monday morning from TorqueNews.com. Tesla has delivered the first batch of Model Y electric vehicles with BYD batteries. According to customer data, the vehicle demonstrates high charging performance, charging from 11% to 71% in only 15 minutes. By the way, how is your charging? Let me know in the comment section below, friends. Tesla has delivered so the first batch of rear-wheel drive Model Y versions with BYD batteries from Giga Berlin factory in Germany. This is the first time Tesla has used BYD batteries for production of its electric vehicles. And some customers have already posted data on the charging power and SOC of the new model on the TFF forum. According to CSEV Tech website, the new car still uses integrated casting technology for the front and rear ends. The difference lies in the batteries, which is now supplied by BYD. According to the data, the rear-wheel drive versions with BYD batteries has a capacity of 55 kilowatt hour and a charge of 440 kilometers. That's 273 miles if you are in the United States. Although the battery capacity is lower than in the long range and performance versions, this new car's performance in terms of charging is very good. The peak power of the new car can be maintained in the 170 kilowatt plus range for a long time, and the power at a later stage is also higher than the CATL LFP version battery, which Tesla has been using also. It can also charge from 11% to 71% in 15 minutes. The Model Y with a CATL LFP battery has similar initial charging characteristics, but power drops off quickly afterward, and at 50%, it can only support about 110 kilowatt. The BYD Blade battery can support about 172 kilowatt until the battery level is 50%, and then it drops at around 90%. Thus, the charging performance of Model Y with a Blade battery is more impressive than the CATL version throughout the entire charging process. Now, some people may think that Tesla will lean toward buying more BYD Blade batteries, and that things may not go really well for CATL, which is the Chinese company, has been supplying Tesla batteries for a long time. But friends, it's not all bad news for CATL, as the company is now rumored to be in talks with Tesla for its next generation M3P phosphate batteries. But neither company confirmed the rumors or if the M3P phosphate batteries would be making their way into Teslas anytime soon. Have you heard anything about that? Let me know in the comment section, friends. This is Armin Harayan from TorqueNews.com, and let's move to our next story. Tesla is demolishing and updating a production line at its Fremont factory, perhaps to roll out the mass production of one of its revised vehicle designs, new filings show. Friends, finally, Tesla's Fremont factory is getting much needed modernization so it can catch up to the newer gigafactories, just as they stated would happen after Giga Texas is able to pick up the slack. Does anyone recall how many Model 3 lines there are in Fremont? I think they have several, but it's good that they are working on them. Tesla applied to demolish multiple equipment, tools, and utilities lines at the Fremont factory on last Thursday, and the timing aligns with the recent images of the Project Highland Model 3 that continue to leak. So we can say that probably Tesla is demolishing the current Model 3 line, or at least one of them, to prepare way for a new updated Project Highland Model 3. Do you agree with this assessment? In the past, we have reported on Tesla updating lines at Fremont after the equipment used has aged or needs to be replaced for other reasons. Tesla does not demolish entire lines with the installation of updated equipment. Instead, Tesla files the line revisions as improvements, upgrades, or revisions, but not as demolitions. The demolition of a production line and the installation of a new one might suggest Tesla is moving forward with the imminent mass production of its Project Highland Model 3, which has already been shown to have a vast different front end design compared to the current vehicle. Tesla could be preparing for mass production of the new Highland Model 3 with the introduction of completely new manufacturing lines. Model 3 production has taken place at Fremont factory since the car was first built in 2017. The only other factory Tesla builds the Model 3 is Giga Shanghai in China. Rumors have recently suggested Tesla would build the new Model 3 there, but Tesla denied those rumors, which points the finger toward the Fremont factory, hence the upgrades and modernizations in the factory's Model 3 lines. Perhaps these new filings are an indication that Fremont will be the initial location for Model 3 Highland production, and Tesla will begin rolling out the new design in the coming months as it prepares to update the vehicle. Updates at Fremont factory have continued to occur for months, and battery manufacturing equipment has also been added or revised at the plant for several months to make way for Cybertruck pack production. So what do you think about all these developments, friends? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. This is Armin Haraya from TorqueNews.com. Take a look at this close and very crisp look at the Tesla Cybertruck, friends. Yesterday, Tesla displayed its long-expected Cybertruck at the stockholder meeting, and a YouTuber, Gregor Truck, took a clear, crisp walk-around of the truck from the back and one side. But this walk-around shows some very interesting hidden details that I want to talk about in this video. Welcome back, everyone. This is Armin Haraya from TorqueNews.com. If you are here first time, please take a moment and subscribe to this channel and ring the bell so you don't miss, guys, my next Tesla or electric vehicle coverage. First, it looks like there is a button on the B and C pillars to open the doors of the Cybertruck. Now, this could be a capacitive sensor, but I wonder how it works in cold weather, especially if the owner has gloves. Some people say that they are still hoping that there will be a bench seat front in the Cybertruck, but that seems less and less likely. That's half the reason I wanted the Cybertruck, so that it could sit six people, writes one user in Tesla Reddit discussion board. Now, what's interesting is that in the case of Tesla Cybertruck, friends, we see a very kind of silly concept vehicle going to make it to production essentially unaltered, essentially without much change. And Cybertruck is already a mainstream vehicle that should sell in high volume, not a brand boosting stunt. Another hidden thing we see in this video is that it provides a nice view of the inside of the sail panels. Looks like there is some storage there accessed from inside the bed. It looks so good in my opinion, but one person suggests to take with grain of salt, of course, but I last heard that the sail panels are gone because part of the rear wheel steering components now take the space. So what do you think about that? Now look at the corners of the Cybertruck. It keeps I keep thinking that the corners on the window are going to be a liability issue. Even watching Elon get out of the truck during the lithium refinery groundbreaking, it looks like he almost took his eye out from the door's upper corner. What do you think about that? Yet another interesting thing we noticed has to do with how Tesla placed the windshield in the Cybertruck. The windshield seems to have a bit of curvature in it. Why not completely flat? Surely that should be a cheaper to make, right? But others say it looks completely flat to them. They add that the bottom edge is a curve similar to the curved nose. So what do you think about that, friends? Anyway, this is very interesting, looks very close and sharp. The Tesla Cybertruck could potentially start production in the coming weeks, friends, and Tesla has been spotted testing some increasing more refined prototypes that are getting closer to the production version of the Cybertruck. Tesla was spotted testing the Cybertruck's suspension on its Fremont factory test truck last month. The latest information released by Tesla puts the start of Cybertruck production this summer for the first deliveries at the end of quarter 3 2023. Are you a reservation holder? What do you think? Have you heard anything that your Cybertruck is on its way by the end of this year? This is Armin Haraya from TorqueNews.com. Please subscribe to this channel, ring the bell so you don't miss my coverage. Let me know your thoughts about about this video and like it if you can, and let's move on to our next story.